Good afternoon and welcome back to the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception here in Camden, New Jersey, and for our eighth edition of our pipe organ recital series featuring this very fine musical instrument that I'm sitting at now. My name is Andrew Ennis and I am the organist here at the Cathedral, and I am so happy to be here with you on this very warm August Wednesday. Hopefully wherever you are, you're staying cool and about to enjoy some music today coming from the pipes of this wonderful instrument. I'd like to thank Mike Bedix for having me back, and I also would like to thank Father Fisher, my rector, and Bishop Sullivan for all of the support that they give me during the year here at this cathedral and all of the support that they give this wonderful instrument. Speaking of support, if you would like to give to our organ fund, it is an ongoing adventure, and you can find it at the Cathedral of the Immaculate Conception website, and anything helps immensely to help keep this musical instrument going forward across the 130 years that it has already been playing. So any generosity is greatly appreciated. So for my I'll talk again through all of my pieces of music before I go and play, that way I don't have to speak through it again. My first piece that I will play is called Cathedrals by Louis Vierne. Vierne was the organist at the Cathedral of Notre Dame de Paris, and he was a wonderful musician. He was actually a blind organist, and one of the interesting facts about Vierne was one day while he was playing Mass, he released his final chord from playing Mass, and he hunched over at the console and there died. It is a very interesting and sad story for Vierne, but he died playing his favorite organ and in the most amazing of spaces. Vierne wrote a set of music called the 24 Pieces de Fantaisie, and in the fourth suite is this third movement called Cathedrals. And I like to really think of this piece of music as a programmatic piece. And while Vierne may not have really intended it to be that, I think it does tell a story, and that of a pilgrimage on their way to the cathedral. You'll hear the tune being played in the pedal, a slow march. That tune will constantly keep coming back. And then you'll hear the people's trials and tribulations throughout the way, some detours and deviations, and maybe some troubles with each other along the way. But meanwhile, always keeping this steady procession to the cathedral. Eventually, you might hear that they see the cathedral in the distance, and then they start to pick up their pace, and they start to run and sprint into the cathedral, and you'll hear them burst open the doors and look up in the space in wonder. And then the piece ends, I believe, in a very quiet and lovely prayer. After that, I will play probably my big piece on the program, which is called Fantasy Prelude by Charles McPherson, who was the sub-organist at St. Paul's Cathedral, London. This program has a little bit of a cathedral theme going on. And this piece of music is a wonderful expanse of different ideas and different types of organ music inside of this piece of music. It's a wonderful expanse, lots of color. You'll really hear the organ get to do what she does best in this piece. After that, I will play a piece of music called Retrospection by Robert Elmore, who was a Philadelphia composer and organist. And I believe that Robert Elmore's music is just wonderful. He wrote just beautiful tunes, and that will be just a lovely little something after the Fantasy Prelude. And for my final piece, I will play just a very fun processional by William Matthias. So once again, my name's Andrew Ennis. Thank you so much for being with me today at the cathedral, and I hope that you enjoy this wonderful musical instrument.